Hi, I'm Grace Fagan and I'm the curator with Kilkenny Civic Trust, and this is part two of our Throwback Thursday series, and I'm sitting here in the beautiful Lady Eleanor's suite, newly refurbished in Butler House. And I just wanted to take the opportunity to give you a little bit of background, I suppose, on the Butler family and who were they and how did they arrive in Kilkenny. And Butler House, as you might already know, is the dower house of Kilkenny Castle. And what a dower house is it's a type of property that would have been built for the widow of the lord of the manor or whatever the position might be. But because in tradition, you know, titles and property rights and ownership and all that kind of thing went through the male line, when whoever it was as in charge passed away, if his heir and son was unmarried, the widow got to stay in the main property, in this case Kilkenny Castle, and then when the heir married, the widow had to move out into her own property, and if the heir was already married by the time her husband died, then she had to move straight out. So Sir Walter, who was the 16th Earl of Ormond, he built essentially Butler House for Lady Eleanor, who was to be his widow. We're a little unclear as to whether Eleanor and Walter moved in here together before his death, or whether she only moved in after his death, but not a bad dower house as it goes. And I think you can see in some properties a kind of, there's a sense of how much affection or esteem that the woman was held in as to how close the dower house was built to the main property. So I can see Pray Tower of Kilkenny Castle from here, so they obviously were they liked her, I think. But Lady Eleanor herself, you know, I don't know an awful lot about her, to be perfectly honest. I mean, again, the history books are written often about the men and the power that they held. When it comes to Lady Eleanor, we'll have a few more snippets about her to come, but of note really is her daughter, also Lady Eleanor, who caused a bit of a scandal in the 18th century, she became one of the ladies of Clangochlin. And again, we'll give you more about that later on as a whole of the story. But that's Butler House in a very strange little nutshell for you, and the beautiful new Lady Eleanor suite.